What is up, guys? Boulder here. Welcome back to another episode of Fire Emblem Fates Birthright. We're going to do a quick couple things before we hop into Chapter 9. We're going to do the lottery, because I don't know what we can really win from this. I think it'd be cool to kind of just try our luck at the lottery for a few episodes, see if we can get anything good. We got two fish. Apparently, it's not very good. I haven't seen fish here yet, so what do I know? And we are going to do my room, and I have... There we go, because they pop up on the bottom screen. So, Setsuna, sure, you're an archer. You're kind of neat. Why the fuck not? These are kind of interesting. I didn't fall into a single trap on the way here. Hello. Okay. They're not like... It's nothing too... I guess they're not like supports. You know, like supports have like full like conversation back and forth. These, I don't know, it's still kind of interesting to see. Because you're seeing like the... Was it the live 2D model? And they have a full voice acted line. But yeah, we got two support. We got a support with Felicia and a support with Hinoka. Let's do Felicia. How much that really stings? Hey, Felicia, I just saw a big pile of broken dishes. Did you... Oh, wow, that's a big cut on your forehead. Are you alright? Here, let me take a look. We should put some ointment on this. I'm so useless, I can't even carry a few stupid dishes around. I wish I could serve you like a proper maid, or at least stop breaking things. And you wouldn't have to look after me all the time. Oh, come on, Felicia. We're practically family, and family helps each other out. Besides, it's the least I could do for someone who saved my life.
I saved your life?
Don't you remember? It was when I had that terrible fever years ago. I just kept getting sicker and sicker.
Oh, yes, I do remember. It was around the same time Flora and I started serving as your maids, correct? But even then, I was a mess. I couldn't care for you properly at all. I had no idea what to do when you fell ill.
Well, you didn't know the normal ways to treat an illness. It's true. But that didn't matter. You kept my fever down for days using your ice powers, drawing the heat out of me and into yourself. They said it was extremely dangerous. You could have died.
It was the only thing I could think to do at the time.
Did you ever stop to consider what might have happened to you? I'm grateful, of course, but I don't want you sacrificing yourself for my sake, okay? I want you to look out for yourself, too.
Lord Poldo, you don't understand. I was looking out for myself.
What do you mean?
Never mind. Forget I said anything.
Felicia, wait. Interesting. I definitely want to see that A support. Hinoka. So our first one with Hinoka. Was that a Winnie just now? Oh, I think I see Hinoka. It must be your Pegasus, I heard.
There you go. Feels good, doesn't it? Oh, don't get your feathers all ruffled. It just makes it harder to brush you. We've been partners for a while. It was so long ago that I chose to be a Sky Knight.
Oh, sorry, Hinoka. I didn't mean to interrupt you.
Hi, Poldo. It's not a problem at all. What can I do for you?
Well, I overheard you talking about you... when you decided to become a Sky Knight. I'm actually curious why you did it.
I don't know if it's a story I should tell you. No, that's wrong. Now that we're reunited, I can share it with you. After you were kidnapped, I was so mad I didn't know what to do with myself. On several occasions, I snuck out of the castle thinking I could come save you.
Really?
But I always stopped. I was always stopped either by castle staff, Ryoma, or Mother herself. I was just so angry that those Nordians had stolen you away from us. I was mad at myself for not being able to do anything about it.
Hinoka?
As I got older, I realized that I was trying to do the impossible. I was so young, there was no way I could walk through all of Nor and save you. And then one day I saw a Pegasus flying.
So that was when you decided to become a Sky Knight?
Indeed. That decision has driven almost everything I've done since then. It's really made me into the person I am today, much stronger and determined. I suppose I should thank you, Poldo, even though I wish you'd been spared it.
I'm the one who should be thanking you. If anything hadn't turned out exactly as they did, I'd have needed you to save me. Thank you, Hinoka. Well, that's sweet. Alright. So, random change of clothes, I understand. And I don't know if we've already done this in this episode or not. But I'll explain in just a second. if you saw the original upload, then you already know. Or if you saw, and especially if you saw my comment or things on Twitter, then you already know. You know what, Rinka? How you doing, Rinka?
What is it?
You're not going to lecture me on my temperkin, are you?
You're so friendly. Glad I met someone like you.
All right. So there is Rinka in my room. So, the episode, for whatever reason, didn't record any of the audio, and I refuse to just leave that be. I've done it in the past where I just have left videos with no audio, but I have the save to go back and re-record, so that is what we're going to be doing. So, you know, I started, we're going to be getting Chapter 9, Land of the Gods. I started the episode, there's no sound. I went through the supports, which I can't recreate because the support's already done. We're in Izumo, and I'm in these clothes because I just got home from an opera, and I needed to get recording ASAP. Did not have time to change, so enjoy the nice, you know, shirt and tie as we played some Fire Emblem. So, Azura, we're finally here, Izumo. It's beautiful, I had no idea.
Yes, some call this place the Kingdom of the Gods. Even when other kingdoms are at war, Izumo has remained neutral. It almost seems too good to be true.
Who's there? Oh, visitors from Hoshido. We seek information about two of our friends who may have passed this way.
Will you please give us permission to enter your territory?
Ah, Lady Azura, of course. People from the Kingdom of Hoshido are always welcome within our borders. I will notify the palace, and someone will be with you shortly.
Thank you.
Excuse me, before you go. We're looking for Lord Ryoma and Lord Takumi. We believe they were involved in a battle near your borders. Do you have any information about them? A battle around here? No, I don't think so. Really? Nothing? Sir Izumo has been a neutral territory for many generations. There's simply no way a battle could have been staged around here. Ah, it seems we're ready to welcome you. Please, come this way. Very well. Azura, do you think he's telling the truth? How could they have not known about a battle around here?
I don't know, Poltooth. This all feels a little strange. Let's proceed with caution.
All right.
Well,
I'm not quite sure what we're supposed to do now. Just wait around until someone arrives?
Yes, this is probably just a bit of formal grandstanding. I heard that Archduke Izana likes to make people wait a few minutes. Yeah.
Well, as long as he eventually shows up with some answers for us. And right on cue. So if you already watched the video, because I left it up for those of you who wanted to watch it even without the sound. I did not like this guy, but my buddy Kynem messaged me. It gave me a different perspective on this guy. He just, the way his mannerisms and everything that he enjoys doing sounds like, you know, your gay best friend. If you don't have a gay best friend, then maybe you don't know what I'm saying. I have two gay best friends. I can relate quite well. So, we're going to try and give this man, you know, sassy gay friend voice best as I can. So, let's just get with it. Wow, is that the Archduke? He looks so serene.
I never met him, but I think it must be. And you're right about his looks. He's almost oddly calm. This actually makes me nervous.
Welcome. Lord, Archduke Izana, may I call you Lord? Please, call me anything you like. Welcome, welcome. Can I get you anything fizzy or bubbly? Anything wibbly or wobbly?
He's a little different than I expected.
Pardon me. I didn't even introduce myself.
I'm Archduke Izana.
Voted best hair in Izumo 5 years running. I'm so happy to have visitors from Hoshido. Now, what kind of weird stuff do y'all like? Do you get in the back of the homeland? What kind of stuff do you like to get into back in the homeland? Okay, I read that all types are wrong.
No, never mind. We'll get into all that later. Let's just sit back and relax and put on some slippers right now, right? Am I right?
Yeah, you're right. Thank you.
Archduke, before we get into the slippers, we have some important questions for you. Are you aware of a recent battle between Hoshido and Nor in this area?
A recent battle? Ha, not likely. I'd be the first one to know about it. You know, because I'm Archduke. Giddy up. Ha!
I see.
Maybe we're in the wrong place.
What?
Now hold on just a minute, partner. You're in the right place of all. Or you're in the rightest places of all. He's on his house. But now that you mention a battle, I do see some of you that are wounded. Gosh, we can't have that now, can we? Not with all the resources I have here. Guys, we've got some great healers and doctors in my kingdom.
Yes, I've heard about the healers here. They're supposed to be the best.
Excellent. We certainly could use a little bit of rejuvenation. Of course, we can't stay long, but it seems wise to heal our wounds while we can.
Perhaps.
Come on now.
Well, I won't take no for an answer. Let's get started with treatments right away. Come on, everyone. Let's head over to the spa.
Thank you so very much.
Thank you, Archduke.
Ooh, what do we have here? You look pretty banged up, my little lady. And your friend Poldy, was it? Well, you're looking a little bit frazzled as well. Tell you what, I got something special in mind for the two of you. Deep restorative healing is what I call it. It means the body and soothes the mind. What do you say?
What? Just the two of us?
I'm not sure we're the only ones with significant wounds, but perhaps we should just play along.
Come on, guys, hot towels won't stay hot forever.
I really like Azana now that Kynum has helped me put that perspective on him. It's pretty dark in here. I guess that must help with the relaxation. I wonder what all these sharp-looking devices are for.
This is the best.
Welcome.
Archduke, are we in the right place? This is the deep relaxation chamber?
Oh, yes. You will go to sleep literally forever in this room. It's our execution chamber.
Wait a minute.
Big brother!
But, Poldy, we're surrounded.
What are you playing at, Izana? This is not funny.
Well, they haven't even reached the punchline yet. I'm not Izana. Boom!
It's been a while, hasn't it, young Poldu? Or don't you remember me? I'm Zola, Dark Mage of Nor.
Am I supposed to be impressed? I don't care who you are. All I care about is what you've done with Izana.
What? Why would you care about that creep? I'm the one who's finally captured the famous Poldu. I'm the one who matters. Anyway, good luck getting yourself and Princess Sakura out of this.
Alright, stay behind me, Sakura.
What are you going to do? There are too many of them.
Prepare to die.
Here we go. Get rused. What's going on? Are they attacking each other?
No, idiots, what are you doing?
So luckily, Hinoka saw right through his ploy.
This is some healing treatment, or this is some healing treatment for our hosts have arranged for us, eh?
Hinoka, how did you know?
This can't be happening.
Very impressive, Lady Hinoka. You are right on all counts.
I too had my doubts about this situation. Thank you for acting on your instincts, Hinoka.
Thank you so very much.
I'm so glad you guys are here.
How in the world did you suspect anything? My Izana disguise was perfect! No matter, I still have enough power to defeat you, the joke is still on you!
You're supposed Archduke acted a buffoon. No royalty would behave like that.
Precisely.
How dare you! My impression was flawless! Move forth, men! Take them out!
Get ready, everyone. We've still got a fight on our hands. Alright. Oh, we have a support. Oh, because I went to my room with Rinka. So let's get our first support with Rinka. We have not had this yet. Alright. Rinka, over here.
Did you need something done?
Sort of. I'd like to ask your opinion on something. Take a look at this map. If we are positioned here and the enemy attacks from here, what should we do? If unit detached and came at us from the river, do you think they'd cluster? If so, we could hit them with a volley, but if we fail, the attacking force might rout. Rinka, are you listening to me?
You know as well as I am, I'm not a tactician. Why are you here? Hoping to make friends? I'm sorry to disappoint you. I'm just here to carry out orders, nothing more. Farewell.
Hey, wait, I'm not done talking yet.
I have nothing to discuss with you. Leave me alone.
You know I can't do that. We're allies. I have to be able to communicate with you.
That's not what I want, or that's not what I meant. I will still listen to and follow any orders you want to give, but otherwise do not speak to me.
What is wrong with you?
My apologies. Perhaps I went too far. There's no way to talk to one superior. I'm grateful you spared my life when I was your prisoner, and I will follow you wherever you decide to lead us. However, I neither need nor desire your attention. Please leave me alone.
Hard to get, huh? Kind of like that. But I believe Setsuna and Kaze. No. I recorded this and the next chapter. And Hayato, he's just falling flat. Orochi's gonna take his spot, and that'll be. Oh, come on! All right. So rout the enemy. I have done this quite a few times, so if we speed through this, I apologize. I'm also kind of crunched for time at the moment. Where's Silas? There you are. So, okay, how do I want to do this? Okay, go here, attack this guy. I'm starting to learn more and more how, like, I have found that, like, pairing up isn't necessarily the option. You know, like, Awakening, pairing up was the way to win. You pair up and you just win. This game, you pair up, you don't dual strike. You get the stats from pairing up, but that's really all that you can achieve. Uh, Saizo, I need you here. Mozu. Oh shit, that was. God damn it. I screwed that up. Definitely screwed that up. In that case. Let's put some people. Yeah, I really screwed this one up. Well, I can take you out with Hinoka. Hit him up with that pine branch. It's actually a branch. I thought it was just like a clever name. No, it's actually a giant log. Wow, okay. Fine by me. Put Rinka here. It's decent. 12, 15 damage. Why not? That's assuming we both hit, which we do. And we get hit in return. Meh. Not a huge deal. I might be able to take him out. Let's see what we can do. We sing for Mozu. Azura gets to level 8, or sorry, 9. Strength, skill, luck. I'll take it. I'll take it. Actually, I can't really do anything. Okay, well, and I'll just go here, and I'll just... I guess I'll just end my turn. I should have moved some people around. Saizo is really good at the start of this. Oh, we might be restarting. I should have used the Dragonstone. Dragonstone adds so much added defense that not having it equipped is kind of nasty, and I think we just died. Yep. Alright. Alright, Saizo's in the right place this time around. So I should just be able to go here. Body this guy. No problem. Goodbye. And then come out here. Equip the Dragon Stone so I don't get bodied again. And then I can come out here with Silas. Finish him off. And then Hinoka. Pine Branch. We hit both of them. Awesome. Don't support. Finish him off. There we go. So this is much better, and I'm getting rid of the animations just for a little bit. Not gonna keep them this way. But the original video was like an hour and a few. I want to try and speed things up a bit, which is why it might have seemed at the beginning like oh, why is that animation on? At the beginning that I was kind of rushing the text. Other animation's off, so why? Oh, because I held L. Got it. Alright. So these guys, like, I'm going to skip this phase. Nothing of importance is going to happen. Saizel does hit level 9 while killing the mage who tried to kill him and failed miserably. There are... Oh, yeah, I forgot to mention... The north part of the map has two chests. I believe one has a speed wing, which we definitely want, and one has, I think, 5,000 gold. So these two outlaws will be trying to get at those. We also have four dragon veins. I was like, well, I don't remember what they're called. Dragon veins, and I only want one coming at me. Alright. Let's go here. Heal you up. What was that? Oh, yeah. The dragon manes, they heal your entire party to full. Like, or, yeah, all of your units, it heals them to full. Which is actually really amazing. Alright, good job, Hinoka. And we got this guy coming through. Shouldn't be a problem, especially... Well, no, I won't put Silas there. I will put Orochi there. And I will... sing for Orochi just to sing. I'll put Silas here. I'll put myself here. And Setsuna can go this way as well. End will be attacked on two fronts. And Felicia actually got quite damaged. I maybe should watch that. Oh, it stopped anyway. So we still got a little more. Please miss. Nope, 63%. All right. I get hit by those, apparently. He can land 63%. I can't land 68%. Fair. Oh, look. What's going on here? I thought we were in Izumo. I guess the whole Neutral Kingdom thing isn't working out for him anymore. Anyway, do you see Lord Takumi anywhere? I didn't get much info out of those Norian soldiers. Perhaps that's because you tied them up and gagged them for questioning them.
Can't be helped.
You know you would have done the same thing. You would have done the same thing. You know it. I'll type as many people as I need to track down Lord Takumi. Whatever. I just wish you were the one missing. Then it would just be me and Lord Takumi relaxing in an Izumo sauna. Keep it yourself. Anyway, we've got some work to do. Maybe these guys can lead us to Lord Takumi. You're right. I can't stand these Norian scum. If they've done anything to harm our master, I don't know what I'll do. Okay, get a hold of yourself. If you kill them all on a bloody rampage, then where will we be? You're right, I will decimate them with calculated efficiency, but spare a few. Let's go! So, she's kind of insane. I dig it. Hit this man up with a nice steel shuriken. Dropping his stats. Gonna need a little help over here, I believe. Let's see, what can we do? This guy, I'm not too worried about. Like, Setsuna, bodied. Straight up bodied. And Setsuna levels up. Hit level 5. Skills, not great. Not great. Let's try this again. Okay. And then I could not finish you off. Hinoka can come down here, finish you off, even though I probably shouldn't use the pine branch because I had 64% accuracy there. That just is kind of asking to lose HP and... God, these level ups. What have I done? What have I done? I don't understand. Goodbye. Okay, Rinka hit level D. Oh, I don't have an extra weapon for you. Oops. Yep, get bodied. Saizo! Did you really just do that to me? Man. I gotta remember, holding L while they're doing their thing makes the animation actually happen. Alright, finish him off. And then we should 9 times... If I do this, Dragonstone... Okay, I take 4 damage. And then come up here with Silas, finish him off. Silas getting low. I really like Silas, by the way. Like, I wasn't sure I was gonna feel about him. Strength, HP and strength, nice. But he's doing a pretty damn good job, if I do say so myself. Let's go over here. Alright. Ooh. Thank you for missing. And get bodied.
I won't forget this.
Okay, this isn't bad. Hello? 11 damage if he hits, please don't hit. He doesn't. And take some damage and your stat's gone. Just get rid of him. There we go. Alright, so they're gonna be trying to reach me. Because that's who they need to talk to. They're not gonna actually talk to me. They're gonna get as close as they can. 9 times 4. Fuck it. I said 9 times, or 9 plus 4. Sorry. That was actually really stupid of me. Whoops. Tsubaki, come over here, I suppose. come down here with Azura. And finish you off. Just get out. There we go, Orochi. Orochi getting a level. Level 6. HP, magic, skills, luck, and defense. Awesome. Mozu. Can't get the kill, so if I go here with size. Ah, oh, too much damage. 9. I move here with Felicia. I do 14. And then I can finish off with Mozu, for sure. I need to see Mozu's animations. Her trembling. I think it's a really great touch, and I love it. I love it. Alright. So now it's just time to make sure people don't get bodied. I keep pressing L for this. I keep saying don't press L when you're healing. Clearly I'm not learning. Alright. So I do want them to actually get the items. It saves me time from having to walk all the way up there and whatnot. Alright, so we're gonna talk to Hinata. You're not with Zola. Whose side are you on? Lord Poldo, you don't know who I am? I'm afraid not. Should I?
Right.
Ha, probably. The name's Hinata. I'm Lord Takumi's retainer. Fortunately, we became separated on the battlefield. We're doing everything we can to track him down, but we're running out of ideas. Will you help us find him? Yeah, of course. That's why we're all here, too. It looks like we must be on the right track since we've all arrived at the same location. Thank you, Lord Poldo. It's big of you to put aside your differences and help us find Takumi. Especially after some of the things he's been saying. Really, though, that man is rude AF. The shit he says to me and about me. He needs to be put down. Absolutely put down. I did it again. Alright. So, these steps and these steps make reinforcements, but if you're standing on them, it can't stop the reinforcements. There we go. I didn't press L that time. I almost did. I definitely almost did. But they're not ambush reinforcements, so I should be fine. Who else needs to be moved? Oh, Setsuna. Alright. End our turn. So, Speedwing, absolutely need it. I'm kind of disappointed. It seems like most of the stat boosters in this game didn't get, like, a special symbol. They're just, like, I don't know, it just seems lazy. Like, why get rid of the symbols for Speedwings and whatnot? Tainor scum! Hold on with Oshido. Wait, who are you? You seem familiar. I'm Poldo. And who are you? Oh, Lord Takumi's brother. It's nice to finally meet you. I'm Oboro, Lord Takumi's retainer. Have you seen him? We can't find him anywhere.
No, but we're hopeful that he's not far from here. We could use your assistance tracking him. Will you join us? I only ask that you temper your zeal for killing Norians moderately.
Yes, of course. It's just every time I see one of those evil jerks, I just start to rage. Ah! But if I keep my thoughts focused on my dear Takumi, I can control myself. I'll do my best to assist you, Lord Poldo.
Thank you, Oboro. Good to have you with us. So both of these people are actually really, really good. Oboro comes with Enmity, which is plus 3 to Norians. Same skill as Rinka. And then Swap, which is really useful. Like you can walk up to someone and press Swap, and you'll swap their position. Really, really awesome. Hinata has triple threat. If a sword lands or axe hit, drops HP to 50% or less, foe suffers half the damage. So it's kind of like a counter with conditions. I think it's pretty cool. Alright. Hit him up with that ox. Boom. Boom. Still using that branch and actually hitting things, which is awesome. 4 plus 6... risky. Oh yeah, very risky, because I'll die if I miss. Let's attack this guy. We'll do 8 plus 17, or 17, 8 plus 7. Why am I missing these, like, high 80s? skip that. Alright. So... how do I want to do with this? Now, I could finish this guy off as long as I hit. Please hit. He's dead. I didn't... okay, I hit on the first try, too, which was what I wanted to happen. Go here. 77. Tsubaki, don't let me down. Please don't let me down. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Mozu, hitting level 6 with skill, speed, and luck. Can bring Saizo out here. Heal people up. Azura hitting level 10. Awesome. HP, speed, and luck, and she learns rally luck. And I will do the same thing, heal up Rinka. And Bo. Let's fight Bo with Bo. Actually, no, I want you there. Alright. So, there's the 5 grand. And the bow comes in. 10 damage if he hits us. Does he hit us? He does not! We dodge that. And I just realized, like, Samurai, Jesus. I didn't even see him move. He just, like, boom, there. Alright, so another bow over on this side. He does hit us. And we didn't hit 80. I'm getting so, like, screwed from all of this terrible, terrible RNG. Where's Akka? Or Azura? He's been called Aqua once in this game, yet. I guess because, like, I knew her as Aqua before the game was out. And, like, anytime, like, I searched for the song, it was Aqua's song, not Azura's song. Alright, so. Let's get a move on. Let's have Tsubaki, Orochi, maybe Felicia come this way. I pressed L. I definitely pressed L. Because I do want to take these guys out. Well, I think it's Route the Enemy. I think I have to take them out. Alright, there we go. And we will head this way. Is it you? Alright, Setsuna, let's go. And actually, think I'm going to... oh, no, I got... well, hold on. Can you reach the... oh, you can't reach the vein. In that case, I will just do it this way. I was going to put Silas here and then hit the vein, heal up everyone, but I'll just do it this way. So Silas is still joining in on the pair. And he might get attacked, but... Who else hasn't moved? Oh, Saizo! Okay, so they came back on this side. I do know there were multiple... is that enough? Yeah, it's actually perfect. That kills them. This kills the man. Gone. But you see how fast it's like, boom! This guy, Hinata, by the way, is also the reason... Speedwing and 1,000 gold. It's also the reason I let Hannah go. Or Hana, whichever one it actually is. Let's weaken his defenses. Hello? Sorry about the weird jump cut there. I don't know where exactly we left off. I just looked at my audio recording and it decided, nah. Nah, I'm just gonna stop. Nothing is going right for the chapter 9 and 10 recording. Nothing is going the way it should. Nothing's being very smooth. I have to re-record, and even the re-recording is not cooperating. I'm looking visually at the audio, so I know the game audio is working, but God, why'd you have to screw up my voice like that? Why? What did I do? What did I do to deserve this? Goodbye. All right. Orochi, hitting level 7, HP, magic, and skill. Alright. Want to kind of hurry this up. So let's see here. Setsuna. Finish him off. There you go, girl. Get yourself a level. Hitting level 7. Wait, what we got? Or 6, sorry. Okay, wait. That was barely a change. Oh. Skill, and that's it. I'm not allowed to have nice things in this game. It's just not allowed, apparently. Alright, so... Silas can... Never mind. I was like, Silas can finish him off. We are kind of in trouble here. This is the only thing I can really do. I have to hope I hit. Okay. Good job, Silas. Thank you for hitting that. If you didn't, I honestly have no idea what we would have done. Hinata, give me that Dragon Bane Bliss. Because Hinata, if you notice on the bottom screen, everyone with a little crown has access to Dragon Bane. So if ever in doubt, look for the crown. That's definitely a kill. No, it's not, because Orochi missed. Thanks, Orochi. Tsubaki, finish him off. Alright. So, let's get this going. The mages will tail me. I'm not too worried about them, honestly. Aqua. I definitely need you back in the action, because... You're falling behind. I need your extra movement. Or letting someone have extra movement, rather. Let's see here. 11 times 2, that'll kill. But you also kill me. Alright, 16 damage. Orochi, finish him off. Orochi, you're really testing my patience. Really testing my patience. Ah, shit. Yeah, I have to do that. Otherwise, Orochi, you might die. It blocks Orochi off. Actually, if I go here with Setsuna, sing. Perfect. Perfect. Thank you. Alright. Move up here. Mozu. I would love for Mozu to kill the boss. Because I believe I got her a higher level than this the first time I went through this map. Because we'll definitely need it in the next map. Without providing spoilers, it's going to be needed. For sure. Silas, do you want to... 16 plus... Hell yeah, Silas! Kill him dead. Kill him dead. I really like Silas. Like... His name's a bit weird. Definitely a bit weird. But, just, like, his aesthetic and everything. That's, like, I'll be honest. I'm not a huge fan of all of this, like, East Asian... Or rather, I should say... Ooh, we got Shelter. Which, is essentially, like you can walk into someone to pair them up. Shelter is kind of like Rescue, but it's pair up. So, like, I can sit here, I can Shelter, I can pull Saizo into Silas, which will have them paired up. But he's pulling instead of having someone walk into, you know? Let's go here. 18, okay. Now I could... Let's see... 11... Why? Why do I have to miss all of these 80s? Why? What have I done? I pressed L. Ugh. And Silas isn't gonna join in on this one? Really? Let me give myself some options. No one's joining in on this one. Oh. Okay. Then I would just chill out. I would just move everyone around. Sing for Sakura. I pressed L again. All right. Oh, so he's gonna Javelin. I was wondering if he was gonna stay with Javelin or go to a bow. He stayed with Javelin, alright. Silas, don't fuck this up again. Oh, there's actually no way I can fuck this up. 100% accuracy. Okay. He's hurt. Trust me, I know. I see it. Heal up with Sakura, and then I can finish him off here, become the dragon, and bodied. So now we got the bow guy to worry about, which is actually fine. Swap Saizo, kill him dead. Well, I say kill him dead. At 85%, I missed those, apparently. Didn't miss those that time. But, you know, things aren't going my way. Saizo, hitting level 10. Magic skill, speed, and luck. And he learns Poison Strike was actually really, really good. And a chess key. So Poison Strike, enemies lose up to 20% HP after any combat this unit, or after this unit initiates. So if I go into combat, and say I do 19 damage, he has 20 HP, poison will take him out. This poison strike. It's really good. So there's just like a little bit of extra residual damage there. Alright, so I believe one more turn is all this will take. Well, I don't know. Like, see, this dude, he has Mjolnir with no skill? Oh, no, Mjolnir itself deals extra damage on crit, and it has high crit chance. So, I want, like, the way I need to handle this guy is have him doing the least amount of accuracy possible. Because I don't want to get critted. If you don't know, crits, if the crit pops, 100% accuracy. See, like, 80% hit, 17 crit. I'm dying, because the crit is already triple damage, right? So nothing fun is going to come of this. Nothing fun at all. If I do this, I do 16 plus 5, he has 45% chance to hit. I see, ready to die, I'm going to enjoy this. Okay, he missed. And there's the poison doing an extra 7, so he's down to 7 HP. Mozu, how much damage do you do? Please, Mozu. Please. Please. I've been missing 80s all map. Yes! Yes! Got him. Ugh, what was I thinking? You weren't, apparently. Mozu didn't get a full level from that, but we got a Master Seal. And the map's over. Game over, Zola. Now tell us where you're keeping Izana.
No!
What do you mean, no? You're beaten!
Oh my, how naive you are. What a sheltered life you've lived. I'd rather die than give you anything. Luckily, I won't have to. Pa!
What is the... what do you say? He's using some kind of smokescreen.
Bingo, until next time, fools!
And some kind of magic is stopping him. Tree magic. Something we've seen only one time, but that was Leo, wasn't it?
Yeah! What are you doing? Let me go!
So Leo's here. No. No. Leo, what are you doing here? Zola, you've embarrassed our kingdom for the last time.
My lord, please, you don't mean that. I was just attempting to preserve my dignity.
Dignity, what would you know about that? You're done here.
Yeah, no!
Leo, what are you going to do? Zola's a monster. I'm going to make the world a better place. But he's one of your own. I refuse to believe you'd harm a fellow Norian.
Why should I listen to a traitor like you?
Why should I listen to a traitor like you? You abandoned us. You have no right to tell me what to do. Leo, please. Fine, keep this pitiful fool if you like him so much. Goodbye, Poldu. When the time is right, you'll pay for what you've done. Damn. Leo, wait, it doesn't have to be this way.
I've never seen such a display of power.
Yes, Lord Leo is a gifted dark mage. He's feared and respected in Nor. He's certainly changed since the time I've spent here, since the time I've spent there. The Leo I remember was kind and curious, even clumsy at times. I wonder what happened to him. Poor Leo.
Oh, my hero.
Whew, you guys saved me. This calls for a feast. No better idea. And all my party will wear pajamas and eat bonbons. Let's get started. Azana in the house.
Is this still Zola?
No, but I think we underestimated Zola's Izana impression.
Yeah, it was pretty spot on. Archduke Izana, before we get to the bonbons, I have a few questions. Have you witnessed any nearby conflicts involving Norians?
Oh yeah, definitely. What a bunch of party poopers they were. We were just listening to some music and getting massages, and then I heard like a big explosion or something outside. And I went to go what was on, and they captured me. I was still wearing my silk PJs. Anyway, we're all about love, peace, and chicken grease here in Izumo, so we don't exactly have a world-class military force. I don't know what happened after that. I was in my own jail. Luckily, I previously had the cell equipped with velvet sheets and scented candles. Best sleep I've had in weeks.
I'm sorry you had to suffer through all that.
Yes, it's despicable for Nor to take advantage of a neutral realm like this. Archduke Izana, I know you've been confined to a luxuriously appointed cell, but would you happen to know anything about my brothers Ryoma and Takumi?
Well, I've heard of them. That's something, right?
I did overhear that the battle stretched all the way to the bottomless canyon. Maybe they just fell in?
Gods, no!
Can uphold yourself, Sakura. Your brothers are not the type to accidentally fall into a canyon. We've got to believe that the both of them are alive and healthy. I'm sorry, that was rude of me to speculate something like that. It was just that the canyon is totally treacherous, such a hazard. Anyway, maybe I can help by reading your fortune.
I'm a bit skeptical of fortune-telling, but this is your kingdom.
Yep, and I'm a descendant of the gods. Really pretty sweet deal for me. Alright, here we go. Oh, ancient gods.
What's up?
I ask that you please answer. Oh, I'm getting something. In the white light, a hand reaches through. A double-edged blade cuts your heart in two. Awaken dreams fade away. Embrace the brand new day. Can it be? Well,
is that it?
It's like I'm working my magic here. Alright, I'm done.
Oh, that's it?
I'm sorry, but that wasn't very helpful. Hey, what can I tell you? I don't make the fortunes up. I just read them.
Very well, let's just move on.
Sounds good to me. I'm dying for something bubbly to drink. Who wants to join me in the sauna? Alright, you'll probably want to hurry off and find your friends. Well, there's no rush. I peeked in their fortunes just a little bit now. Oh, and I can tell that they're both doing okay at the moment.
Hey, are you sure? I'd really like to believe that.
I swear it on my gold-plated statue myself. They're fine. Thank
you. Well, thank you, Archduke Izana, for your hospitality and service as a fortune teller. It's tempting to stay and rest, but we'll leave now and search for our brothers.
Oh, I knew it. Oh, well. Come back again sometime. We'll have a toga party.
I don't know what that is, but okay. Take care. I like him much better this way. Much better. I can't stop thinking about the fortune Izana read for us. Those words were so poetic. A double-edged blade. Embrace the brand new day.
Poldu, I must speak with you.
Is everything okay?
Yes, well, I don't know, actually. It's about that fortune.
It was strange, wasn't it? And a bit haunting, too.
Yes, those were the words to a song my mother taught me as a child.
Are you certain? Do you remember the meaning behind the lyrics?
No, it's an ancient song. But this is what troubles me. The lyrics almost speak directly to you.
To me? How is that possible?
I don't know. The song has always been a bit of a mystery, but I've never thought about trying to solve it until now.
Perhaps it's just a coincidence, right? I mean, how could someone write a song about me if I hadn't been born? Oh,
Azura. Sushi.
What's the matter?
Apologies. I'm sorry. Please forget about all this.
All right, I'll drop it for now. But please don't hesitate to come speak with me about anything at any time. I'm here for you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Poldu. All right, let's get going, shall we?
Azura?
What was she trying to tell me?
We'll find out at some point, but that's going to do it for this episode. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode and this chapter. I know it seemed a bit rushed, but I am also rushed for time, so, you know. But, yeah, I will see you all next time. Bye!